Morning, October 22nd, 2016. Could be October 23rd. Long night. Love the morning walks on the shores. Good Sunday to you all.
And so God is not getting ready to bless you. He's already blessed you. The thing is, either you're not ready or it's not the time. Because anything that God has purposed, He's already doing it in the earth. And so you need to get ready. Now, God, get ready for what you are going to be. Get ready for what God has promised you. Get ready for what's in your future. And I promise you, as you get ready, your readiness, your preparedness will come in contact with the right time.
Hello, Mother. It is I, your youngest son, your youngest child. Over the course of the last couple of weeks, I've been trying to figure out a way to do something for you, to bring joy to you, you know, give you a smile, something to make you feel better with this current situation, with everything that's going on. So, through a lot of thinking, I finally came up with an idea that I know that will make you happy and will make you smile. So, hold on, let me stabilize this. Sit still right now. There we go. All right. So, you know, we text every day, or I text you every day, and you know, even though we're going through this right now in this current situation, I'm not used to the text. I'm so used to hearing your voice and everything. And I know a lot of stuff is overwhelming for you, but I wanted to let you know that everyone is here for you. And by everyone, I mean a lot of family members who you may not hear from. So I took the time to reach out to a lot of family, a lot of loved ones from all over, you know, and I'll let them tell you what they have to say. They were overwhelmed with joy when I brought this idea and this project up to them. So I'll let them tell you from their own mouth, from their own heart, what they have to say and how they feel. So without further ado, I'll let them get to you. I'll let them talk to you, and I'll be back.
Hello, Mother. Shooting a shout out to you real quick to let you know how much you mean to me and how I feel about you. Well, when it comes to me and the feeling part, I mean, what can I say? You birthed me on Mother's Day. So that's like special right out of the gate. So I've always felt that way. You know that I love you with all my heart, all my being. You know, and I know right now it seems pretty tough, but with all the love and support that you have, we are going to fight through this. And all I can pretty much say is that stay being you. You know, I'm talking about the woman that I've known all my life that has showed me how to be strong, almost more than my father, you know. So just continue to do what it is you need to do and keep fighting. We're all fighting with you. And
hello, Mother. I just want to tell you, give you a little short message to let you know you're my home girl, and all the things that you've instilled in me, beauty, smarts, haven't quite learned how to cook like you yet. I guess that's coming later in age. but you are a fighter, and you've instilled that in us as well, as to be fighters. And you're a spiritual woman, and you have grace and beauty and a bean head. But I love you, Mother. I'm your half pint, and I rock with you forever. Love you.
Your absolute very, very favorite cousin, Rena. I want you to know that I miss you so much and how much you mean to me. You mean the absolute world to me. Keep fighting me. I'm here and I'm fighting with you. I'm praying for you day in and day out. I love you so much.
Hey, Grandma. I just wanted to let you know how much I love you and miss you and how much you really mean to me. And I never, ever, ever take you for granted. You are the best example for a black woman that I could ever have or ask for. And I thank you so much for all the happiness you brought me. I love you so much, Grandma. And I'm praying for you.
Doing this special request clip video to my Grandma Neat to let you know that you're in my prayers as always, and may God bless you with many more years. And how I feel about you, you're a second mom to me and always will be. You know, I can just remember the days, you know, running in the house, you know, telling on John and Brandon, telling you that, you know, they picking on me or messing with me, and I come in the house, Grandma Nee, telling, and all kind of stuff, you know, so I'm always going to be your boogaloo, you know, you're always, like I said, going to be in my mind and in my prayers, so, you know, I can't wait to see you and hug you and kiss you. So, yeah, you'll see me soon. Love you. Bye.
Hey, Auntie Neat. Just dropped in to tell you that I love you and I miss you. And I just want you to keep strong. I was going to write something down to say to you because I didn't know what I was going to say. But I said then it wouldn't be original. And I am original. So, I miss you a lot, and I just want you to keep your head up. I want you to be strong. I want you to be who you built me to be, and that's all you can be, and that's all you can do. I just want to let you know that I've learned a lot from you throughout my life. Again, a part of that is strength. Just striving, being beautiful, being great, just being all I can be in everything and anything that I do. You know, getting to the top. I always used to say as a little girl when I grew up, I wanted to be as pretty as you. I'm getting there. I still got a lot of work to do, but I'm getting there. I just want to tell you that I love you, and you are one of the most important people in my life. Keep strong. I'm praying for you every day. I've always have. I always will, no matter what. I miss you, and I love you. And as soon as I can get to see you, just letting you know I'll be there. Love you, Auntie.
Mrs. Juanita Zinkevich, Mama Manti. That's Mama and Auntie for anybody that's trying to figure out what that means. Because you've been more like a mother than an Auntie. And that's just the kind of woman that you've been. That's the kind of woman that you are since I've known you. When I was a kid, it was like, you know, I had more than one mother. You know, you like to take care of everybody. You have a big heart. One of the coolest, one of the sweetest women that I know. One of the toughest as well. I've said that since I was a kid too, that my auntie is tough as hell. And I appreciate all that.
Auntie, ever since I could remember, you had that confident, strong spirit on you. You walked around with your head up. Never was afraid to speak what was on your mind and what was on your heart. And I just want to let you know that I'm fine with you. I'm praying for you every night. Even though I'm many miles away, I still love you and I think about you every single day. Love you, God.
So, turn my radio down a little bit. Let me tell you a little something about my Aunt Juan. Let me tell you what I've learned from her. I've learned how to be sarcastic with that person not even know that it's actually happening to them. Now that's some skill right there. some straight skill and tell you I need to have some sarcasticness at this line of business. You understand? Also, you know, the woman has showed me how to be classy. And, you know, fashion. Fashionista. Yeah, I think that's how I say it. She's all about the fashion. I love it. I love that about her. And also, I can't never hear a Michael Jackson song, Keep It in the Closet, without thinking of her. For real. And that dance, because she sure know how to dance.
Wait. Hold on. Because I really don't think they understand what you mean. So let me just show them real quick. Hold on. Take a look at this. Now do y'all understand what she was saying? But continue. Go ahead.
Her way of dancing. That is. So, love you. I love you, my Aunt Juan. And yeah, me and mine are fighting with you. Love you.
Ciao. Hey, Auntie. It's your nieces. We're, as you can see, have this beautiful background for you to see.
just a slice of Italy. We're at one of the tallest museums in the world, and we just wanted to share a little bit of that with you. We also wanted to share with you how much we love, respect, and appreciate you.
You mean the world to us.
You do.
I respect you. You've always been an inspiration to me, from your style to your grace.
You've always given good advice. You've always been so knowledgeable and you know, understanding to all of our situations.
Always somebody we can call and talk to and never feel any kind of way about it.
Absolutely. So. We love you for that and more. You're our heart. We can't even describe how much we love you, but just know that we do.
We're always with you. Even though we're not right there with you,
we're there for you. And we're always fighting for you. So,
TMO, we love you.
Bye. When I think about my aunt Neat, I think of Diva. She is a diva, honey. And, I think I get a little of my diva-ness from her. She's everything. She's strong. She's confident. She's beautiful. She's intelligent. She's sweet. She's literally everything. So I just want her to know that I am fighting with her. Love you, Auntie.
Hey, Auntie/Mom. Just come to let you know how much I love you, how much I care about you. I've been struggling all week trying to find the perfect words to say, but there's no other perfect words than I love you. Love you.
21 years since I met the greatest lady of my life, my grandma. I'm making this video because I want to let her know that I'm here for her. We all here for you, Grandma. We all love you. I love you very, very much. I miss you. You in my heart, my mind, every day, all day. You mean the world to us, Grandma. Love you.
Hey, Grandma. It's a video to you to tell you how much you mean to me and what you mean to me. It's like take number 10. I just want it to be perfect. But it seemed like I can't fit everything that I want to say to you in 30 seconds. I just want to keep going on and on about how you showed me and taught me everything, made me the man that I am. You've made me the husband that I want to be. Looking at your marriage and the joy that you took in raising your family, our family, even your great grandkids. Say hi. Say hi. Just me and her right now, chilling. My mom took the rest of the kids and stuff out. I thought it'd be a good opportunity to sit down while the house was quiet and tell you how much you mean to me. I mean, I love you. I miss you every day. Pray for a full recovery. really don't know how to make a long story short, but I do miss you a lot, and I want you to know I'm encouraged by your power and your strength. You've taught me so much. You've even taught me how to talk to girls. You've raised this man, the man that I am today. It's all because of you. I say that I'm thankful, I'm grateful to have a woman like you in my life. I love you.
Hello, Rose. This is your daughter-in-law. For those that don't know, we call each other, me and my mother-in-law, we call each other Rose. It's kind of like our little thing. Wanted to let you know that I'm thinking about you and praying for you every day, day in and day out. Wanted to personally thank you for some of the things that you have helped me with over the previous years, and distinctively I can remember 2006 was a really rough year for me, and you helped me so much get through that year. I had little John in 2006, and my mom, she had just moved out of town in 2006, and you helped me adjust to motherhood and just helped me overcome some of the things that becoming a new mother brings. So I really want to just thank you for helping me that part of my life and my journey with becoming a mother, a new mother, and a new wife. And I want to also thank you for showing me how to make sweet potato pie. That's like my favorite around the holidays. And you helped me, you taught me how to make that. And it's like one of my favorite desserts. So I just wanted to come on here and tell you how much we thinking about you and praying for you, and can't wait to see you soon. So love you and see you soon.
She is everything. She is the mom.com. Do you hear me? I love everything about her, especially her beauty, because she know how to slay it. She done taught me so much on how to wear this and how to wear that. She's an overall amazing person. I miss her so much, especially during holidays, being able to go to her house and kick it and be in the backyard and partying and hanging with the rest of the family. I know I might not see you every day, I might not talk to you every day, but I want you to know that I love you so much and I'm fighting for you.
What's up, Muddy? This is Sean, the arm. Yeah, I want to let you know a few things. You know, what I think of you. Well, I got a list of it. You cool. You got a class of your own. You smart. You're a teacher of many things. You're courageous. Perseverance. Funny. Loving. Caring. Black power. A feminist. A teacher of many things. So smart. This is just a few things among many other things. This is just a few things among many other things that makes you such an awesome woman. But the best thing of them all, out of all of it, I would have to say, is you being my mama. Never stop being you, lady. I love you.
Hey, Auntie, Squirty Bird dropping by on Candy Cam. I just want to let you know that I love you so very much. You've always been a part of my life, literally, almost every day. I just want to let you know, even though that I don't call every week, like the last time I promised, it's not a day that I don't go by thinking about you. I think about you every single day. You know, you're like a mother to me. And I just wanted to know that I love you very much. Stay fabulous. Stay healthy.
Bye. Some of my finest
memories with my aunt is, you know, she was one of the original soccer mom, minivan driving, bad MFs rolling around. And for her to be a soccer mom with the minivan, none of her kids play soccer. You know what I'm saying? But all my aunties all had tribes of kids. So there's always plenty of kids to be carting around everywhere. So she was, you know, smart about it. She got a minivan. You have to see how my auntie drove this minivan. She leaned to the side to put more pressure on the gas pedal to get more out of that motherfucker. Funniest shit I ever saw. I think I ever seen anybody drive a minivan faster than my aunt. And I think my second fondest memory is where you got all my aunties slaving in the kitchen, cooking this, baking that, cooking that. And my auntie will walk in and set a beautiful cake or a pie down. And they'd be like, dang, how long did it take you to make that? Oh, not long. Because she went and bought it from the store. Funniest shit ever. Like, she rarely baked anything, but she knew where to go buy the good baked goods. And that's what she spent her money on. Like, why I need to bake it when I can go buy it and it's right there. One thing I can say I get from all my aunts is they taught us how to love. They taught us what love was. They taught us tough love. They taught us love. And how to survive and make something out of ourselves. Like, you find it's hard to find some of us that ain't doing shit with our life because they push us to be ambitious and go for what we want and do what we do. That's why a lot of us are successful. And Auntie, I love you for that. Like, you pushed me to be more than what I want to be. You and my other aunts, all y'all was instrumental in me doing what I do. We make boss moves every day because we grew up with bosses. Period. Love.
Hey, moms, this Big Head checking in. Just want to tell you I love you. Keep strong. Keep going hard. Stay strong. Me and the family, moms and everybody, we praying for you. Love you.
We have a lot in common. As you can see, when I come home to Michael Jackson. So I love it, I love it. I heard some great things about you and Michael. So I just wanted to share with you what you mean to me. What all started when your son tried to court my daughter. He came over with, what did he have? Valentine's Day card, roses, and candy. And they said they just want to be friends. I was like, right. So I came over to your house, fast forward, and asked you 100 questions, and you did kick me out. So I love you for that. What I wanted to talk about, though, was my baby girl and how you embraced her. And you enjoyed them having a friendship, as you said. When Keisha would get lost, I would call you and say, where's Keisha? She over here. She keeping me company. I'm teaching her how to bake. I'm like, okay, right. So I'm like, okay. I said, you watching them? Yeah, I'm watching them. Well, pops out the oven, Lil Jon. Right, they were baking. But that's what I love about you and I. We have that in common. We promoted that young love and they got married. And then here comes, oh, by the way, yes, that's the same outfit. That's Lil Jon. And as you can see, that is Keisha in the flesh. And out comes Ja'Kai. So there's Ja'Kai. And there's Lil Jon. And there's Keisha. So the family is growing. And all these little boys, I guess Leia said, hold on. Princess Leia arrived. She was like, hey, y'all ain't leaving me out. All these little boys, let me come take over. So there we have three beautiful grandkids. So I guess I could imagine Zach looking down here saying, hold on a minute. You know, that looks pretty good, and you know that you doing good, Nita. And then Jack said, you know, hold up. You know, I always mess up names. Zach said, wait a minute. Let me show y'all how it's really done. Bam! There's Jalen. Zach in the flesh. He said, okay, now, that's what I'm talking about. Now, Nita, that looks like us. And that's what I love about you. You promoted that love. You had faith in my daughter. When I didn't, I was like, send her the butt home. And now I am blessed with four beautiful grandchildren. And I just want to thank you and Zach for what you all did with Jon. I'm so proud of him. He's just like my son. And I'm going to need you to get on over here. Diva D. That's what I used to call you because you put the D in Diva. And I just appreciated you, the person you was. You take care of these grandchildren. And I love you and I need you here. And I just want you to know that God loves you, and you help bring life into this world with your belief. And Jesus came to give us life, and life more abundantly. And I just want to remind you, because I know you know this, that we don't have to ask Jesus for our healing, because by his stripes, you are healed. And we have to remember that, because I have to remember it. And thank him for our healing. And I'm gonna need you to stop playing and come on over here with me, girl, so we can show them how these mother-in-laws do it. And you know what? I got a new name for us too. Now, I don't really know what Diva means, but it's like a jazzy lady, but we're gonna be the Jesus Divas, okay? So I'm gonna need you to get on over here to the A, hang out with your girl, holler at your girl. Come on, girl. That's what I'm talking about. I love you, sweetie. Look forward to seeing you soon.
I'm back. Now, wasn't that fun? It was really exciting. Didn't know who to expect, didn't know who was coming. Hope you really enjoyed the video, the film. It's a little nifty outside today. Excuse me, wasn't expecting this, but I hope you really enjoyed it as much as I did and everyone else who partaked and had something to do with this video. Hope you really enjoyed
the sincerity that came from everyone making this video. You know, we all had fun doing it, and it was just, you know, such a thrill, in my opinion, you know, just to see what everyone was thinking and how everyone, you know, just the memories and, you know, just sharing everything and hearing how everyone speak about you and such a great woman you are. So I just want you to know that, you know, I love you. We all love you. Everyone who was in this film and many more who didn't get a chance to help, you know, didn't get a chance to partake in the video, you know, to help make and everything, you know. So we love you. We love you. We love you. We love you. We can't stress that enough, mother. And, you know, we here. We here for you. You got this. You getting through this. This is one day at a time. We got this, mama. Don't you worry about nothing. So, love you more. Love you more. Love you more. Love you more. You know, I'll talk to you later. Love you, mama.
Yeah.